This is historic. This is the first landfalling tropical storm in Southern California since September 25th, 1939. So it's been a few decades since this actually last occurred. So it's definitely a very rare occurrence. But it's just a combination of the atmospheric wind flow and also just the ocean temperatures, you know, in the eastern Pacific that allowed it to come up to the north there and eventually come on shore across San Diego and give us what was very, very significant rainfall for mid-August. Very significant. Climate change affects the overall atmospheric and oceanic conditions that definitely then impacts the strength and the impact of any particular weather event, whether like say it be wind or rain, hurricanes, whatever it might be. Hilary formed and became a category 4 hurricane. Then as it continued moving north, you know, over the coastal waters there, it gradually weakened. By the time it came onshore at the Mexican border, it was a tropical storm, which means like wind speed or wind gusts between 39 and 74 miles per hour. Then as the storm continued to move northward, it continued to weaken, and then it weakens to a point where it's like even weaker, like a post-tropical depression or something like that. And it just means it means it's weaker, more disorganized, the winds are a lot less and so forth. But when it came on shore, it did come on shore down near the San Diego area as a tropical storm. Well, we did receive, you look at the rainfall totals across Southern California, coastal areas received upwards of 4 to 5 inches. In the mountains and deserts, you had upwards of some areas in excess of 10 inches of rainfall. So with that much rainfall in such a short period of time, there are many reports of flooding. I'm sure you've seen some things on social media, you know, especially like in the Ucaipa area, Oak Glen, out in the deserts like Palm Springs and things like that. A lot of significant flooding. I think you potentially see, you know, things like this happen in the future. Anything on the immediate horizon? Obviously not, but I think potential is always going to be there because this proved this did occur, you know, first time since 39.